That senior class was very motivated, very focused, you know, realizing they had one last chance, that we were a team that could definitely win a state championship.
So we knew coming into our senior year, you know, having four seniors, a lot of underclassmen, that, you know, we were going to be good, but that didn't mean anything. You know, we had to put all that work in.
We definitely had a lot of motivation. I know all four of us seniors, we got together, we just said we have a lot on the plate that we need to still fulfill.
We knew we had one more time to go, and we had to give it our all in the off season and during season, and we had to prep the underclassmen who maybe didn't have as much experience.
Made sure that we instilled the idea of getting better in the younger girls as well, because we knew that they were going to be a huge part of our success this year.
I think everyone knew that this year was going to have to be different if we wanted to make a run.
After coming up short of their ultimate goal of winning the school's first ever state championship the last two seasons, the 2016-2017 Homestead girls basketball team once again made that coveted state title their main goal this season. But unlike the last few years, there was an actual realization that this could, in fact, be the last legitimate chance to accomplish that goal. With a mixture of senior leaders who had tons of game experience back for their final season, to go along with an abundance of underclassmen to help fill in vital roles, the Lady Spartans began the season with huge expectations.
I think we've been really blessed that the past 4 years we've had pressure. We've been number one. We've been one of the best teams in the entire state. And so having that pressure, I think it only made us stronger. And you know, we've always preached that we want the target on our back instead of us trying to chase someone else.
That target has been on our back, but this year especially it was really big. So, you know, we really focused on, you know, every game was important. Every game was an investment.
Our very first practice, Madison Parker came up to me and she told me, "Sydney, we're going to get you a state championship this year. This is a great opportunity. It's a great experience. This is what we're going to do."
But that pressure of being the state's best team wasn't just placed on themselves internally, considering that in the Indiana preseason girls basketball rankings, Homestead became the team to beat statewide when they found themselves as the number one ranked team in the state. It was the off-season workouts and preseason practices where the focus for the season began to take shape, and head coach Rod Parker knew for this team to reach that ultimate goal as the last team standing in the state, the schedule he made carried as much importance as nearly anything else.
To build a schedule is not an easy thing to do in high school, just with contracts and so on, and finding people who will play you and finding the correct dates and so on. But we made a big investment to put together a schedule that gave us opponents that would defend us in different ways, give us a variety of styles of basketball, so that as we went into the postseason, we could reflect back on those previous experiences and help us prepare for future games.
Having that competitive schedule, it really prepares us for what we're going to see in the postseason, playing back-to-back games, you know, on a Saturday to win a regional title.
This year, the schedule was pretty hard. He wanted us to be in every situation we could be possible.
All our games were challenging, and to have challenging games throughout our season every Saturday, it helped us a lot.
Our schedule was awesome this year. It's not often that a team up here in the north is able to play so many teams from Indy and, you know, teams from Ohio, Illinois. So the fact that we got to do that, you know, only helped make us better.
It was a regular season to remember for Homestead as they finished their season for the third consecutive year with a school tying record 21 wins to only two losses. And only one of those was to an Indiana high school team. The Homestead Lady Spartans found themselves as the number two ranked team in Indiana, and the coaches and players knew once the regular season was over, the journey for a state championship was the only thing on everyone's minds.
Right when we came into that first practice after our last game, everyone was just, I think, a lot more focused, a lot more dedicated, and we knew exactly what we needed to do. I feel like there was a lot more energy in the building.
When we went into that postseason, it was we're prepared for this, we're going to go out there, we're going to play hard, we're going to win.
We all realized that, okay, well, if we lose, we're done. So we realized that we need to give it our all in every practice. We can't take anything for granted. We can't take any team for granted, because anything can happen in the postseason.
Knowing that every single practice was an investment for that tournament. So when we got to that tournament time during practices, you know, there was nothing new. It was everything we've been doing for the entire season.
Tuesday, January 31st, the final day of the month, became the starting point to see if these Spartans would be the team to bring Homestead its first ever girls basketball state championship.
23 games to prepare us for tonight. Okay, if there's anything I could take out of those 23 games, okay, it was the competition we played, it was the energy that we played with, and that we battled every possession, okay, for 23 games, just to put ourselves in a position to buy in the tournament and do what we do, okay, and play as well as we can play.
Welcome back to Homestead High School for tonight's girls sectional 6 first round matchup featuring the Jay County Patriots and the Homestead Spartans. I'm Austin Render alongside Matt Schreck. McLaughlin, corner, Parker, down the baseline, down low to Geist, the layup is good. Klein, down low to McLaughlin, blocked from behind, they miss the ball, she finishes, and a foul. Final score, Homestead 81, Jay County 59, and the Homestead Spartans advance to the second round of sectional play with a big-time 22-point victory over a feisty Jay County squad.
Remember this, we all win together and value your contribution. So whatever it is, if it's going in for one defensive stop, get it done and do it well, value it, because that opportunity may be the difference in the game. Understand that. All those possessions in the first quarter, in the second quarter, in the third quarter have an impact on what's going to take place in the fourth quarter. Are we up 9 or 10 shooting free throws when they foul us? Because we've done a good job early on in the game to be in that position to close it out. Okay? That's what we've got to make sure that we do when we're out there.
Welcome back to Spartan Arena on the campus of Homestead High School, preparing you for tonight's sectional number 6 semifinal matchup featuring the Southside Archers and the Homestead Spartans. I'm Austin Render alongside Matt Trek, and sideline reporter Garrett Willis will join us later on in the broadcast. He gets it back, right side for Geist, down low for Graber. Graber inside, Geist layup, rolls off the rim, fights for her own rebound. Swings it out to McLaughlin for three. That's good! McLaughlin right side for Parker with Jackson all over her. Parker thought about a step back. Fires into the corner to Geely. Down the baseline, Geely. Layup is good! Parker in the backcourt in trouble with a double team. Dribbles right through it. Now with numbers. Parker to the basket. The layup is good! Homestead is going to advance to their fifth straight sectional championship with a 73-34 win for the Homestead Spartans, and they will play to try and win their fourth sectional championship in a row tomorrow night in the sectional championship at 7:30.
Everybody has to hit the boards and then we run, okay? Good energy. Listen, if we go to 23-42, make them make the mistakes. Every possession. Offensively, recognize the defense and be sharp. Okay, they're going to throw different stuff at us. They have to. All right, and when they do, react and beat it, and then we'll be on our way.
Welcome back to Spartan Arena on the campus of Homestead High School sectional championship. The Homestead Spartans against the Huntington North Vikings. I'm Austin Render alongside Matt Schreck, sideline reporter Gabe Smith as well. Homestead takes the floor in their home white uniforms, Huntington North in their away black. Haley Swing will tip for the Homestead Spartans. Parker right side for McLaughlin to the corner to Parker. Dribbling out of the right corner, a screen from Swing. Wraparound pass inside on the block to Swing. The up and under is good from Haley Swing. On the run with numbers, McLaughlin down low for Swing, who finishes inside. McLaughlin top of the key, Swing. A pass fake, now to Parker on the right wing. Parker brings it back out right side, now to McLaughlin, who drives, layup good and a foul. McLaughlin will finish and have a chance for a three-point play at the line. Timeout called by Coach Lawson in Huntington North. Not the best of starts for the Vikings. Right now, defensively, no answers for Carissa McLaughlin and the big girls for Homestead.
Well, they've tried to help out on the interior, but then they're late rotating on the outside, and that's leaving Homestead open beyond the arc.
Selking squares up for a three. That's good! Lauren Selking hits the three ball up court to Sophia Buck, and that is it. Homestead, four straight sectional championships with the 93-51 win over the Huntington North Vikings. The Homestead seniors never lose in this building in their 4 years.
I was very excited for them to win that sectional, get four in a row. That was a neat accomplishment for the girls to take with them. And, you know, when you cut down the nets in your home gym, it is something special.
Obviously, I've been around the program a while with my dad. You know, I saw a lot of teams that were good, and you know, they never won the sectional, and I saw it a couple times growing up, but you know, to be able to come in and win it four times with four different group of girls, obviously the seniors stayed the same, but you know, the teams were different every year, so the fact that we were able to come out and get four of them is pretty impressive.
For me, it was super exciting. It was just an amazing feeling to have one of our goals accomplished, one of the milestones building up to the state championship. So knowing that we passed the first stage, it meant a lot to all of us.
Winning four sectionals in 4 years, I mean, it does mean a lot. Having four of those, I think, is an incredible accomplishment.
Homestead, winners of four straight sectionals, were off to a familiar venue the following weekend at regionals. But maybe more so than any other time the last 4 years, the challenge that laid ahead of them this time in Kokomo was a demanding one. Knowing that you'd have to beat the number three and number four teams in the state in one day was unlike anything any other team in the state faced that Saturday in February.
So we put a lot of time into that Zionsville game because we had to win that to obviously get to Carmel.
Knowing that we had one of the hardest regionals in the state and having the hardest draw in that regional was obviously tough, but we knew we could handle it mentally and physically. We knew that we also needed to take one game at a time. Zionsville wasn't just gonna roll over for us.
It was definitely challenging, you know, traveling in the morning, going to watch the Carmel Carroll game in the morning, watching them be really successful, and then knowing that we had to beat Zionsville in order to play them again. Zionsville, a really tough team, has some really great competitors on the team, but you know, we came out there, we did exactly what our game plan was.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome live to historic Memorial Gymnasium in Kokomo, Indiana for today's regional semifinal featuring the 25-1 number 3 Zionsville Eagles and the 24-2 number 2 Homestead Spartans. Now a bounce pass inside for Geist, working inside, had it blocked, gets it back, puts it up, left it short, ball tipped around, Parker comes up with it, and one inside! Parker will go to the line for a three-point play. Down the baseline, McLaughlin drives, layup is good. Left wing, Geist, inside, cutting to the basket. McLaughlin lays it in. Spartans up 9-0. McLaughlin driving, kicking, Parker a three ball, at the horn, knocks it down. Spartans up 18-9 at the end of the first quarter. McLaughlin a jumper, it's good. 14 points for McLaughlin already. Down the lane, the layup way off the mark. Graber, the offensive rebound, the putback, good, and a foul. Sydney Graber will go to the line to complete the three-point play. Parker down the baseline, the jumper is good. Another buzzer beater for Madison Parker. 29-20, Homestead on top.
They're tired, they're on their heels. So offensively, keep pushing the basketball, keep looking for good shots, and then there's nothing wrong with making them defend our offense.
Okay.
And the counters are wide open, okay? But we need to get a couple times, two or three in, okay? We got a good post-touch to Jazz and one, okay? Finish, it's not there, we get it kicked out, okay? Just got to keep that basketball moving, okay? It's the big thing on our offensive end, and keep running our offense. We're going to get good shots and keep running. Now listen, our 27th game and the 27th speech I've given you about third quarters, right? Okay? And we've gone out all year long, we've won third quarters. Win this third quarter.
Left wing McLaughlin. Top of the key for Parker. She'll let a three-pointer fly. That's good. Parker in the double figures with 11. Backs it out, resets for the Spartans. 7:05 to go in the third. 32-20 Homestead. Klein, Geist. Driving to the basket, Jasmine Geist got it to go with the left hand. McLaughlin to the basket, lays it in. Spartans up by 16. Timeout, Coach McGuire in Zionsville. Spartans up 17 with a basketball, 2:13 to go in the third. Left wing Klein, three on its way, left it short. Offensive rebound, Graber inside, layup is good. Spartans are all over Zionsville. 40-21 with two to go in the third. The Spartans will be moving on to their third straight regional championship where they've won the last two. They'll try and defend their title tonight at 8 o'clock. Spartans win 52-38 over the third-ranked Zionsville Eagles. And the Spartans will advance to the regional championship to take on Carmel tonight at 8 o'clock.
It was a long day, you know, during the break because you had such an adrenaline high in that first game and then you had to cool off a little bit. But, you know, I thought our team did a good job of, you know, staying off our feet, resting, doing some fun things, you know, together, some team bonding.
Clear our mind off because, you know, we kind of have to get away from basketball for a couple hours. And so then after that happens, everyone just kind of gathers together and does their own routine, pregame routine. And we just go down the lobby and Coach Parker, he talks what our game plan was. And that's when it all gets serious.
For the sixth time since the 2014 season, Homestead and Carmel prepared to face off. And for the second season in a row, they battled for a regional championship. This time, however, the Spartans knew what it was like to lose to the Greyhounds and wanted nothing more than to avenge their regular season loss.
Winning against Zionsville first game, Coach told us that we could celebrate, but once we get out of the locker room, we have another game. It's not over yet. The journey's not over, so we need to focus on the next game, get ourselves prepared, our bodies rested, and focus on Carmel.
We knew that we were going to play Carmel again. We rested up and we knew that this was our second chance, that we had to go get this.
About 2 hours before the start of the Carmel game, everyone was focused again. You know, we had our fun, we had our rest, but then it was game time again.
Hey, great defensive transition, great energy on defense. Make sure we communicate, 5-1 out there, okay? Play great, stop containment, good patience, run our stuff on offense, recognize the defense. Yeah. A lot of energy out there. Come on. Hey, championship game. Let's go get one. Let's go. 1, 2, 3.
Fight! Welcome back to historic Memorial Gymnasium. It's a regional championship matchup between the Homestead Spartans and the Carmel Greyhounds. I'm Austin Render alongside Matt Schrack and Gabe Smith. Corner McLaughlin down the baseline, top shot, rims out, swing the offensive board and the putback. McLaughlin, a shot fake, a fire from three, it's good! Right side for Parker. Parker down low, Geis working inside. Geis clears some space and finishes. Double teamed on the right side, gets out of it. Here's Parker, she'll step into a three ball, that's good! Madison Parker knocks down a three. Pass to McLaughlin, top of the key. McLaughlin, step back, three ball, good. What a move by Carissa McLaughlin. Left side Klein, three ball in its way, that's good. A lot of energy in this building as Klein knocks down the three. Homestead 19, Carmel 13 at halftime. Low scoring, low possession game with a lot of turnovers. Right. Spartans up by six.
Work hard and we're rebounding well. Okay, keep rotating, okay, so on. Now, offensively, okay, number one, we've got some looks, okay? We've got some looks, we've got to make them. That's all I can say at this point in time is keep working and get the shots. But we've got to get early up a little bit quicker into our offenses, okay? So when the basketball, if we can push it, if we don't get anything out of it, when we push and we get up into here, get that into our offense.
We need to run on this first play right here, okay?
We go 10, we're gonna score out of it, okay? Open the floor up. 1, 2, 3.
Fire!
McLaughlin, she'll drive, pull up, off the glass and in. Up court Parker, she'll drive, down the baseline, pulls up for the jumper and knocks it down. McLaughlin, dribbling to the right side. Being set with all kinds of defenders, opposite block, Geist laying, good! A screen from Geist. Parker sent with a double team, dribbling inside, step back, jumper, good! Here's Parker to McLaughlin. McLaughlin, left side, Parker, three ball on its way, good! Madison Parker knocks down the three! McLaughlin, a screen from Geist, dribbling left side, down low, Geist, shot fake, layup, good! Geist to double figures with 10. Geely, left side, Geist. Back to Geely. Parker on the left wing, a screen from Geist. Parker attacking down the baseline, inside, Graber the lay-in! Why not? 6:02 to go in the fourth. 48-29, Homestead their biggest lead at 19.
We were just clicking. I mean, everyone was hitting the shots they needed to. I think our defense was incredible. We were making all the right reads and doing all the right plays when we needed to.
To be there and be up 19, we knew that we had to keep pushing because Carmel's a good team and, you know, those runs are gonna even out at some point.
They were up 19, folks. It was 48-29, 1:37 to go, 54-53 Spartans.
Not being able to come back in the game was devastating, and I knew I just needed to stay positive for my teammates, because if I was down, then everyone else was going to be down.
I looked at Madison and Krista, you know, one of your two hands, we're going to get to the line, you're going to bring this thing home for us.
We just need to stay composed, stay mature. You know, we have faith in our younger girls on this team, and we know that we're prepared for this moment, so we're just going to go out here and have fun with it. And, you know, we have to compete to the very end.
Carissa, she was telling us it was going to be okay. We just got to play our game. It was just, she's being a really great leader, role model, and it was good to look up to her at that time.
They were going to make a run, and they did. And when they were shooting free throws at the end, I remember, you know, this could swing one or two ways, but I knew that we all wanted it bad enough that we weren't going to let it slip out of our hands.
Us seniors were like, hey, we are still up. Like, this is a big game, and we knew this is what it was going to end up being. And I was like, we prepared for this, so we did. You know, being up 19, that's a big turn of events. But, you know, we prepared for that close game. So when it got that close, I thought we did a good job of, you know, staying mature, working together, and getting the job done.
8.5 seconds. Here's Dilt racing up the court. Taiwo, three ball. No good. The rebound, Sears. And that's it. The Spartans are regional champions for the third year in a row. 63-59. It's a three-peat, and the Spartans are going back to semi-state.
It was kind of shocking. You know, I was super excited, but so much relieved because, you know, that was the big game.
I think there was a lot of relief because knowing that we had the hardest regional to stay, it was going to be tough for us to get out.
We wanted that ultimate title, and a regional was a big stepping stone in that, especially when we drew Zionsville and then Carmel. You know, that was a big task for us. So when that game ended and we were on the winning side, we were all pretty elated, pretty excited, and felt pretty good to accomplish that together.
Regional day, it's really hectic, and knowing that we had to win two huge games, it was really stressful. So knowing that we finally won those two games, it was just kind of a sigh of relief.
We are we're going to practice for another week. Now, let me say this, okay? I can't tell you how proud I am the way we competed today in those two basketball games. Okay, to knock off two top four teams in the state of Indiana 4A the same day is tough. And listen, I'm going to tell you what. We did it because we competed. We did it because we played together, okay? And we played great defense. Okay, you defended unbelievably today, okay, and I'm proud of that. You had people stymied. And then at the end, okay, in all honesty, it took guts and it took winners to pull that out, and we got it done. Good job. Let's get it in. Yeah! And I'm proud of you. Congratulate yourselves and enjoy this, okay? We got a lot of work to do this week, okay? We got another big one next week. 1, 2, 3.
The Memorial Gymnasium of Kokomo is such a historic and neat place. And we left the floor, and there's a great hallway along the back with low, you know, ceilings and everything. And the coaching staff came in, and we had to walk about the length of the court to get to our locker room. And I said, enjoy this walk. And when we made that walk, there really was kind of a sense of relief, because this team played under a lot of pressure all year, you know, with expectations, not only from the community, from themselves, but, you know, the media, et cetera. And I was really happy for them to get through that day and play as well as they did.
Normally, each round you advance in the tourney is more challenging than the previous one. But after Homestead's regional win over two of the top four teams in the state, most media outlets were predicting an easy victory in the semi-state. This Homestead team, however, understood you couldn't overlook any opponent in the state tournament.
When the media clippings are saying, oh, they got them by 20, you know, every game is going to be a tough game. I mean, you feel like every team is going to go out there and give it their best.
A lot of people are like, you know what, you're favored. And we're like, it doesn't matter, you know, it's a semi-state game. If you make it to a semi-state, you're a good team. So we knew we had to come out and get the job done. It was one game standing between us and the game we were hoping to get to all year.
Coach Barker told us all week in practice, we can't let outside sources get into our head, and we can't go thinking, oh, we're going to win. This is just like a regular game, like every other game. We just have to take care of business like we have been doing.
If we're going to go out and get our goal and our prize and get to the opportunity to get to Bankers Life the following week, we had to remain focused that week simply and solely on Northridge and what they do. And so the kids stayed very focused, I thought, on that particular game.
The seniors, the whole bus ride, we can do it. This is our chance. We got to win semi-state.
Welcome back to Crown Point High School for today's semi-state championship. featuring the Northridge Raiders and the Homestead Spartans. I'm Austin Render alongside Matt Schreck, our sideline reporter. Garrett Willis, as well as Gabe Smith, will join us later on.
Hey, expect the man. Don't be surprised at changes, okay? A lot of mature young boys out there, all right? Work hard. Get a good start in this basketball game.
Save it, guys. Go, ladies.
Energy is within us. Let's go. One, two, three.
Fire!
Trying to get inside on Miller. Nothing there. Here's Parker left wing for Klein, working on Bontrager. Top of the key for Geis. Rotates it around to Parker on the right wing. A minute 15 in. Here's McLaughlin, a three ball in the corner. That's good. Klein spinning around on the right-hand dribble. Down the baseline, Klein gets a layup and buries it. Here's McLaughlin on the run. McLaughlin down low, Geist working on a double team. The floater is good. McLaughlin pull up three. That's good. Parker straightaway three. That's good. McLaughlin with a head of steam. Across the timeline, driving, kicking, Klein, a corner three ball, that's good! McLaughlin down the baseline, pulls up for a jumper and buries it. McLaughlin with 17, and that will finish off the first half. 38-21, Homestead leading by 17.
And I like the way we defend the basketball. We're doing a lot of good things there, okay? You take away these and these, you come to about 11 or 13 points, okay? So we've got to make sure we clean all this up right here. Does that make sense? Now, offensively, keep looking to push the basketball. We're getting good looks, okay? We're getting good shots.
McLaughlin, left wing to Geely. Geely in the corner to Parker, down the baseline, dumps to Geis, layup is good. Spartans all over the Raiders, up 24. Right side, Parker, looking inside, lobs to Geis, a double team sent her way, off the glass and in. Up court for McLaughlin. McLaughlin down the sideline, dribbling to the basket. McLaughlin, the lay-in is good. And for the second time in school history, the Spartans are heading back to Bankers Life Fieldhouse to compete for a state championship, defeating the Northridge Raiders 63-40 to win their second semi-state championship in school history.
Once we arrived at Crown Point, there was no way that we were going back. I mean, we were not going back to Homestead without a win, a semi-state.
It was pretty cool to know, like, we did it. We got back. You know, that was our goal. Sophomore year, we lost. You know, me and Carissa, while we were standing on the podium, you know, after sophomore year, you know, we said, hey, like, we are going to get back.
It was amazing. This is what we've been striving for since sophomore year, to get back to state, and it was a great feeling.
It's a great feeling to know that we are going to state, and I couldn't believe it because I'm only a sophomore, and I'm just so proud of my team.
It was a really good moment. At first, I didn't like process, oh, we're going to state. But after we got in the locker room, we cheered a lot. And we were like, hey, we're going to state. And it was a really good feeling.
Hey, what do you say, lady? Yeah. Hey. I'm extremely excited, happy, and proud of you, okay, for the effort you put out there. Everything we talked about this week, I thought we came in and we executed. We played maturity and poise. We defended well, and I'm proud of you. You deserve it. Now, this week, okay, it is a fun week, okay, and I'm excited for you to have it, to experience it, and so on. We've got to make sure we understand and we realize we got a basketball game to win, okay? We've worked hard this year, okay? All year, off-season and everything, to put ourselves in this position. So when we go down to Indianapolis this week, okay, we're going down to win. I just going down to play, all right? I'm proud of you. We're heading to Pop Valley and Albany.
Yeah!
Yeah!
Yeah! Yeah!
And as I said, I'll buy about 10 pounds of gummy bears for you for the band.
Yeah!
One, two, three.
Spike!
For the second time in three seasons, Coach Parker and the four seniors got to be a part of state championship week. While it is certainly a week any team would love to experience, the extra attention from the media, to the fans, and even to family members made it a challenging one for a team focusing on playing in the biggest game of their careers.
There's a lot of outside noise during the state finals week. A lot of media coming to the gym, pulling kids out of practice to interview them. But you know, it's a lot of fun, but you have to stay focused and you have to know what we're here for.
3:20 when our practice started and it was game time. We had good practices all week. We were feeling really good, but at the same time, we were having fun because, I mean, it's what you're going to remember for the rest of your life. So while you want to work hard, you also want to mix that in with the unique experiences that come with making it to a state game.
Everyone was on us, like, oh, are you going to win? Are you not? But it was just being mature and staying calm during the whole week and just focusing on the game.
At school, I couldn't focus at all. I was just thinking of winning, what it would be like to be in the spotlight, have a state championship for Homestead, the first girls basketball state championship.
They handled it so well, and that goes back to that maturity of the senior group. They really handled, I think, the outside factors such as media and pressure and that kind of stuff, and really deferred it away from the younger kids in our program. And I think that leadership was very important that week, and they knew what to expect, and they handled it very, very well.
Said all the time, the defense wins championships, okay? It's a saying, whatever. But I'm gonna tell you what, we've been playing great defense and it's got us here. So we've got to make sure tonight we play great defense for 32 minutes every possession. This game is gonna be a battle of mental willpower for either team. Who can hang in there every possession and have attention to detail? That's what we've got to make sure we do for 32 minutes. You're holding nothing back. There's no reason to. Ladies, we got to play 32. We know that. Compete with no regrets. No regrets. No matter what happens out there, we compete and we compete for one another. You compete for the person sitting to your right. You compete for the person sitting to your left right now. You owe it to yourself. You owe it to your teammates to get out there and do everything you can. You're diving on the floor. You're taking charges, okay? You're moving the basketball and you trust one another. It's got to be all of us. Now, don't leave this out. We've got to have fun tonight because it is a game. It is a game. So we got to make sure we go out with a lot of visible energy and excitement and just get after it and have fun. And then lastly, we know it. We got to show it to the entire team. We are Homestead, ladies. We got to go out. We got to do what we do. Get a good warm up. Get a feel for the place. And then we got to go out and got to compete hard. Okay. Hey, you guys are prepared, and I've been telling you that all week. It's ours to go get. 1, 2, 3.
Fight! Oh!
And I don't know how much time we have. So I'll just get a feel for it.
Welcome back to Bankers Life Fieldhouse in downtown Indianapolis, Indiana. We're just moments away from the 4A Girls Basketball State Championship between the Homestead Spartans and the Pike Red Devils. I'm Austin Rendell alongside Matt Schreck, our sideline reporters.
I see the dawn of a new beginning. This time, this
comes out. McLaughlin the rebound. The clock hits zero. The Spartans are state champions. They avenge the loss from 2 years ago, and they'll take home a state championship back to Homestead High School for the first time in the girls' basketball history.
I'm speechless, you know. We worked hard for this all season and it finally paid off and it's a great game.
You guys have changed the culture of Homestead basketball forever. I don't know how we're gonna do it without you next year, but thanks for giving us the state title and we all love you.
I just kept smiling ear to ear. I just could not stop smiling. Winning a state title meant everything, knowing that we were not only doing it for ourselves, we were doing it for Homestead, for all of our family and friends and community.
We did it. We did it. We worked so hard, all, you know, 13 of us. Only 12 of us could dress, but, you know, every day in practice, all 13 of us worked for this. And so it was just crazy, you know, first time in school history for the girls program, and to do it together with this team meant a lot.
Wow, we did it. We finally did it. This is what we've been working for. It was a sigh of relief, but it was also kind of bittersweet because, yeah, we won, but now our season's over. I wish we could play another game.
Finally winning state and being able to tell everyone, you know, we are state champs. What we worked for has paid off. It was definitely feeling a relief, and it didn't really hit until the next day. We're like, oh, I have a medal around my neck. Like, we're state champs.
It was a great feeling. I was just so proud of my team, and I'm so happy that we could all experience that moment together.
It means so much to me that our team, we came together as one, and we got the job done. And to accomplish our goal from what we've been looking forward to all season to get the state championship, it was the best feeling in the world.
At first, it was just a mix of emotions, but after we got on the podium, I was like, okay, this is great. It was a great feeling. Blood was rushing, just the crowd. It was just an amazing feeling.
I was extremely excited for those girls because I knew that experience was something that they're going to take on now for the rest of their lives, and they're going to be able to share with their kids and look back in the history books, and nobody can take it away from us. So that was probably my first gratification. For me, it probably sunk into me as a coach probably later that night when the whole team went back and we were having a party, and we had over 100 people, parents and everybody, at the lobby of our hotel. And that's probably when it kind of sunk into me, like, wow, we did this. This is pretty cool.
Because I know your parents want to see you and we celebrate out there, but I can't tell you how proud I am of you guys for getting it done today. And I want to say this: your state championship winning today wasn't a result of what we did today. It's a result of what we've done over the years. It's a result of what we started back on October 17th when we started practice and we stood there in the center of that court and everybody had a goal and everybody had a mission. We talked about the target on our back. We talked about the prizes we were going to go get, all six of them. We got all six of them.
Yeah! Hey,
right down to Miss Martin.
Yeah!
Go on three. One, two, three.
For me, it couldn't have been a better time. You know, my dad coaching me, I really enjoyed, but the fact that my sister was on my team, first time ever that we've actually been on the same team, to win a state championship or a championship of that caliber was pretty cool.
And I've said over the last 4 years of the run we've had with the four sectionals and the regionals and the other appearances that I'm so excited that she was a part of that. And this year, having both Riley and Madison was extremely exciting. So the whole journey, I think that just kind of made it a little bit extra special. I probably didn't realize as much as the season went on because it was about the team. I was excited they were a part of it.
For the first time in Homestead High School history, a celebration for a girls' basketball championship took place. But in reflecting on the journey these 13 girls and four coaches took everyone associated with Homestead on this past season, it wasn't the number of wins on the court, but the friendships and bonds they'll take with them for the rest of their lives.
I'm going to remember the girls I've been playing with this whole season. They have had a huge impact on my life, and I will never forget this.
I'll remember probably my teammates the most. They've all become some of the greatest people I know, and they're all my best friends, and I will never forget them.
I'm going to remember the state championship, of course. Just the games leading up to it, the bus rides on the way down, just all the crazy team dinners, team activities, just the personalities from all of my teammates.
I think being able to see that banner on the wall, if I return, will be one of the greatest feelings, you know, knowing that I was a part of that team and we made school history.
Our team is so close this year. We've had so many great memories on the bus, off the bus, hanging out outside of school. I think that will be my best memory of the year, is having a team that's my best friends and my sisters.
I think when I look back on these seniors in this team, the first thing that I'm going to think about is the chemistry and the good times that we had, probably first, and then we'll smile and say, and the success that we had on the court, cap it off.
Something I'll always remember about the 2017 team that won the state championship is just the friendships that I made and just the everlasting memories on the court and off the court. I mean, you have to have the time to work together off the court and to hang out and have those friendships in order to be successful on the court.
Even though we may be going different places for college and there's years separating us between the younger girls, you know, we always will have a bond because we won state together. You know, that's something that lasts forever. So definitely think we'll stay forever friends.
My teammates are what I'm gonna remember the most. You know, we spent every day together, working together, you know, and like I said, to get this win with this team couldn't have been better. So I can't wait, you know, to come back here and however many years it is, and to see all my teammates, see where they ended up, where they became, and you know, I'm really excited for them in the future. A lot of them have a lot of good potential, and obviously, you know, our senior class is going to be leaving, and so to be able to reconnect with them, hopefully, be pretty exciting.
So when I tell my kids someday, when I bring them here, just be like, you have to enjoy high school, and you have to enjoy the moments that may not seem a whole lot to you right at the moment, but are going to mean a lot down the road, because it's little things like that that are just going to mean a lot. And so this team was special, and I knew it from the very beginning. I just knew there wasn't going to be anything that could stop us from getting exactly what we wanted and exactly what we've been chasing all 4 years. And to experience it with this special team was just truly awesome, and special coaches that I'll definitely have relationships with forever, and I know that I can always rely on them. So this year was just truly something special, and I'll never forget it.
I think the greatest part when you have a season like this year was all the little things along the way. You know, the bus rides, the seeing the excitement and jubilation on their faces after a big win in the locker room, being on the court when they're cutting down nets. All that kind of stuff is, I think, what made it special. And then ultimately, that big week going down to Indianapolis was special and something that we'll cherish for a long time and be able to talk about for many years moving forward.
She's just a pal.
That's the net mix pal. The net mix pal. Carissa killed them.
I've never heard that before.